A lovely evening once more. I was just laughing with my colleagues back there because the previous team started with the story saying, growing up in Malawi, and our story also starts with growing up in Malawi. And so growing up in Malawi actually is quite interesting, and it has been a very wonderful journey. My name is Daniel, and I'm part of Eco Building Systems, and I know you're curious what we are, and so in a minute you get to hear about us. But let me introduce to you Mr. Kondwani Mohone, who is our CEO. Right next to him is Miriam, who is our finance person. And then we have William, who is our sales and marketing. And then we have Mpo, who is our operation manager. Now, growing up, like I said, in Malawi, we were told of stories of how our parents moved from their villages to come here in town to live their lives. And one of the things that happened when we moved here, my parents started a building project of what they considered to be their dream house. And sadly, that hasn't finished up until now. And when I tried and asked them why that was so, they said one of the reasons was the ever-rising cost of building, which brought us to think, what is going on in Malawi? Now, Lilongwe and Malawi in general is growing. In fact, it is estimated that it is growing every year. The urbanization rate is at 6.3% every year, which is considered to be one of the highest in the world, because for a country like the United States, it grows 3% every 30 years. And so with this comes a lot of pressure on the construction materials that are used here in Malawi. And here in Malawi, the main construction material that is used is what they refer to as the pan-baked brick or the fire-cured brick, which is produced from burning clay and making these bricks. And what's wrong with that is that, first of all, it is not a durable product. At the same time, because it is burnt in its production, it requires a lot of trees for it to be made. And so that is one of the problems that we found in the construction industry. But at the same time, we see that the government has come in and said, we are putting a ban on the construction material, which is a traditional way of building. And now they've introduced an alternative, which is the cement block. With the rise of urbanization in cities, we see that there's a second problem that's coming in. High urbanization has created high production of waste. It is estimated that Lilongwe alone produces about 109 tons of waste, of which only 30% is collected and dumped. But from this number, 109 tons, we see that 15% is actually plastic. And you could see, as you're walking around town, there is a lot of plastic within the waste that's there. Now, these two unique problems kind of really got us thinking, and we thought, could there be a way of finding a solution of tackling the two? I'll introduce Mr. Kondwani, who is going to tell us more.
So as Eco Building Systems, we looked at the two unique problems that is facing Malawi and decided to come up with something that could help tackle these two problems. So we've come up with a solution by mixing plastic waste as well as building materials such as sand, stones, quarry stones, to create building materials. For example, in our product line, we're introducing what we're calling the poly brick, the poly block, and our entry to the market, the poly paver. This is an example of a prototype we've created that's made out of plastic and sand to create more or less a paver. So how does the market look like in the building material industry? Well, according to Habitat, UN Habitat, they estimated that since 2010 to 2020, there is a need for approximately 203,000 new households to be built in Malawi to facilitate the high rate of urbanization. This survey was then based on the three major cities of Malawi, that's Lilongwe, Blantyre, and Mzuzu. So this also means that there is a need for about 21,000 new households to be built a year in these three cities. As well as if we were to accomplish this huge task of facilitating households for all these people, we've also seen that there is a possible job generation of up to 29,000 new jobs in the construction industry alone. So who will be our competitors in this industry of construction. First and foremost, our competitor would be the Panbeck brick. This would be a competitor in terms of constructing this or building this building material is very cheap, and hence it's easily available to a lot of people, but its weakness is that they easily break apart. From the time you buy them to installation, you would have probably lost one third of your stock. Another competitor of ours would be the cement block. Its main advantage is that these cement blocks are usually large in size, which means they use less mortar when you're installing. But its disadvantage is that while it's being made, it uses cement. And in Malawi, cement is one of the highest priced goods in the whole of SADC region. Our third competitor is other potential entrants to the market. Obviously, there'll be other companies like us who want to introduce an alternative product. But I think we have an advantage over them in terms of research, because we've been researching this product for a few years now, and I think we'll be ahead of this market in terms of production. Moving forward, what challenges will our company face in this industry? First and foremost, this idea is new to Malawi, so it will take a lot of convincing in terms of our new clientele to tell them that this product is actually safe and it's strong. So being something that's very new, it will take a lot of convincing to show our customers how strong our product is. Another challenge that we have is possibly that Malawi doesn't have a very big recycling culture. So this is something that we have to be introduced in Malawi to tell them you don't have to throw your plastic waste anyhow, and there's other alternatives in how you handle your plastic waste, such as what we're doing. So how will our revenue look like? Well, we've estimated as a company that in our first year of operations, we'll be able to do approximately one housing project per month. According to our survey, an average Malawian household will need approximately 8,000 pavers to pave the household. So our current product is priced at 200 kwacha per paver. So if we're able to cater for one housing project per month, we'll be able to make a revenue of about 1,600,000 Malawi kwacha per month. So what is our initial investment asking? We're asking for $21,000. This will help us in facilitating the opening of our company for the first year, as well as buying most of the equipment that we need to be able to mass produce our product. Thank you very much.